Today's talk, e-heritage. And this is, what is e-heritage? Basically, e-heritage, we try to digitize various cultural heritage in digital form. And then, based on that digital form, we provide various appearance of the form in various space, places. And why we are working this e-heritage? Because heritage itself is priceless, irreplaceable, and vanishing day by day. So it's a good idea to safeguarding in digital form. And also, by using such digital data, we can conduct scientific research and also generate contents for promotion and education of heritage. And that provides good, excellent opportunity in computer vision, computer graphics, and robotics, actually. Now, first segment of my talk is modeling. And in modeling, we try to convert this kind of physical heritage into digital forms. And still in this modeling issue, there are two aspects. One is geometric issues, obtain shape, and photometric issue, how to obtain color and specularity. And first issue is geometry. And in this geometry, as an example, I will explain which I did in Cambodia. And this is South Asia Peninsula, and this is Cambodia, and this is a temple. And next segment video explain what is Bayon Temple. Geometry, as an example, I will explain which I did in Cambodia. And this is South Asia Peninsula, and this is Cambodia, and this is a temple. And next segment video explain what is Bayon Temple.
The Bayon Temple, located at the center of Angkor Thom, unites the outlook on the universe of ancient India and the tradition of Khmer. The temple was constructed around the end of the 12th century to bring relief to the crisis in the Angkor era. It is well known for the appearance of, for example, calm smiling faces on towers and double corridors carved in beautiful, interesting relief.
So this is a Bayon Temple. Why we digitize this temple? Because central tide is inclining and there is a possibility that corruption occur in near future. So it is a good idea to obtain digital form currently, right now. However, this Bayon Temple is a huge structure, 130 meter high. That size provides various research issues. And university professor is easy job. The main job is try to find a difficult problem. And we have an automatic problem solver, namely grad student. So give that topic to grad student and wait 3 years, then result come out. So I use that strategy. However, you know, there are many issues in this. So size demand solutions in all aspects of modeling. And two aspects is how to design new sensor for large scale building and also to develop new softwares to handle large amount of data, terabyte. Sensor design. One challenge is Bayon Temple is a huge structure, so we have to obtain various viewing direction. And of course, you can bring sensor to high positions. And the easiest solution is hang range sensor under the balloon. And this is a scene. And where the, this is a balloon, by the way. This is a sensor. And that is a good idea to bring a sensor to high positions. But bad idea in terms of result. Basically, obtained data is like that, twisted due to the floating balloon. And as I told you, university professors, easy job, when you find this kind of difficult problem, give it to the grad student. And I gave it to one of the grad students, and he came up with good solutions. Given two image sequence and distorted data, and to iterative formulation is extracted by this grad student Bannokun, and then result is this one. So this is a distorted data, and then image sequence like that. Distorted data, image sequence, Bannokun's program provide this kind of data. Another problem, you know, Bayon has narrow corridors, so somehow we have to extract, obtain data like this narrow areas. This is a scene which we are using for sensors. Other sensors, mirror sensors, photometric sensors, whatever. Software design. Basically, again, you know, we obtain data from various viewing directions, so we have to determine relative relations, and also we have to connect all together. And if data is relatively small, there is already commercially available software exists. But we are talking about terabyte data, so we come up to softwares again. Huge amount of data requires a large amount of memory and long computational time, and so we design two-step program, quick pairwise alignment algorithm using GPU, and parallel simultaneous alignment algorithm. Also, various sensors contain reliable and unreliable data. Approach, confidence-based consensus surface margin, and this is the result. 150 meter, and 40 meter structure is represented 1 centimeter resolution. Now, basically, this project was conducted by us. And in Bayon area or Cambodia areas, there are many ruins existing. And we Japanese team can cannot digitize all of them. So what we did was, from point to data, we would like to expand this area all over the Cambodian areas. How? Technology transfer. Originally, digitization was done by us, but currently we are negotiating Cambodian government to digitization by Cambodian team. By technology transfer, data collection will be done by Cambodian team, data processing was done by Cambodian team, by Japanese supplied softwares and hardwares. And one of the targets which we are trying to digitize is a bas relief of Angkor Wat, central monument of Cambodia. And here we are teaching Cambodian people how to digitize and how to use softwares. And this is a scene Cambodian people are working along the Bayon, not Bayon, Angkor Wat corridors. And this is an intermediate result digitized by Cambodian people. Also, this is a shape, so shape. But you know, also we have to obtain photometry too. And this photometry, I'll skip detail. But you know, one issue is digitization was done by range sensors, while a color image is obtained by color cameras. How to obtain relative relation between two sensors? Another issue: Bayon is huge structure where. When you take an image morning and then going back and then coming back evening, and there is a color difference. And yes, we can average this color, but in terms of preserving original color, it is not a good idea to just arbitrary color. Observed color is multiplication of surface color and illumination. And somehow, we have to separate illumination color from surface color. How to remove effect of sun from given pictures. And I'll skip detail, but one of the grad students come up taking the same scene by different period, different time, and from the color difference, she estimated the illumination color and removed the color, and by using that, she obtained original color like that. Thirdly, usually we are using RGB camera, but RGB camera is arbitrary, namely, light itself is a continuous spectrum from 700 nano to 1000 nano, actually. And color camera is just arbitrary sampling one particular positions like that, R, G, B. And sometimes you miss this kind of pulse. And for cultural preservation, this arbitrary RGB is not a good idea. Rather, we have to obtain original spectrum of the wall. And yes, there is a spectrum meta, but this guy only provides point data. Somehow we obtain entire wall of spectrum. So what we did was, we paste this kind of interference filter. Depending on the position, wavelength is different. Passing wavelength is different. And this is a black and white TV camera. And by rotating this one, you can obtain entire wall spectrum. Now, you may wonder what to use this kind of digital data, of course in a preservation. But also by using such data, we can generate this kind of video contents. Video contents, when you visit Bayon Temple under moon, you can see like that situation. That's fine. You can create the video contents too. But more actually. We call this area cyber archaeology. We are conducting some scientific or archaeological research by using 3D data. First of all, of course, by using 3D data, we can generate this kind of cross section. And by using this cross section, we can check how strong that tower is, and we can generate restoration plan based on this data. Visualization of terrace level. By using that, how water flow occurs over the terrace. And again, by using that data, we can set up restoration plan too. Floor plan. We generate the floor plan of Bayon Temple by using 3D data. And somehow, originally I thought this is east-west line, but this is counterclockwise, 0.94 degree. I don't know why. This is the only fact which we obtain. But anyway, entire Bayon structure is rotating 0.94 degree. And again, this is confirmed by using 3D data. Bayon Temple, actually the main reason why I go to Bayon is, in Japan, originally I start this project by scanning Big Buddha in Japan, Kamakura Big Buddha, Nara Big Buddha, Asuka Big Buddha, and then I exhausted all Big Buddha in Japan, so I go to Thailand, I went to Thailand. Then I scan one of the Thai Big Buddha. And at that time, Thai people say, if you go to Cambodia, there is a temple called Bayon, and that Bayon has 173 Big Buddha. Oh, wow, that's a good idea. That is the main reason. And then once we begin to digitize face, well, why don't you digitize the entire structure? That was the history of this Bayon project. But anyway, so Bayon Temple contain 173 faces. And since we obtain 173 all faces digital data, we done cluster analysis. And then it turned out this 173 faces can be classified in three class, Deva, Devata, Asuras. We done cluster analysis. Then there is a similarity group exists nearby locations. One similarity group is here, one similarity group is here, one similarity group is here. Somehow, similar faces exist at proximity positions. And there was a rumor, actually. There is a few independent team of workers exist, and they work in parallel manner. Our finding is corresponding to this rumor. The reason is probably one worker group work here, and also rumor says teacher cave central one and student cave peripheral one. So maybe teacher cave and then student looking the teacher's caving and follow. So there is a similarity group. Another group, teacher cave this one, student cave this one. Another group, teacher cave this one, student cave this one, like that. So our finding again corresponding to the previous rumors. Thirdly, sediment.
Decor engraved on the upper side of the entrances and on windows. The bayon's pediments are framed by two snake gods called Naga, and the inner sides are decorated with carvings of Hindu gods, Buddhas, and Apsaras, which are female spirits of the clouds and waters in Hindu and Buddhist mythology.
So this is a pediment. However, even today you visit the bayon temple, you cannot see these kind of pediment. Before us, there are no picture of this pediment. The reason is, here is a pediment. Narrow is 30 centimeter and height is 5 meters. And there is dark and there are many bugs. So you cannot see. However, we obtain data along 10 centimeter areas by using this range data and connect all together and generate synthesized pediment pictures. This is a synthesized pediment picture. When I gave a similar talk at the UC Berkeley, one of the professor from Buddhist department approached me saying, oh, this is great. I don't know why this is great, but according to him, apparently there was a residue of big Buddha caved out, converted into linga. Meaning, linga is, by the way, a men's symbol, and this is a symbol of the Shiva god in Hinduism. So his interpretation is, this pediment provides evidence that this temple converted from Buddhism to Hinduism. So again, this kind of 3D data provides new finding in archaeology. Painting. In Japan, there is a tumulus called the Ozuka tumulus, and this guy is famous due to that painting. Why? Well, a little bit interesting. But another reason why we make this digitization is this tumulus is closed to public, so no one can see inside. No, except few people, no one can see inside. So we generate video contents of this tumulus, and currently that is displayed in Kyushu National Museum. But at that time, we also obtained spectrum of the wall. In this painting, there are two interpretations. Under what condition this painting was done? Some people say this is done under sunlight. Some people say this is done under torch. So since we obtained spectrum of the wall and the shape of the wall, a shape of the tumulus, we run simulation. How this painting appear under torch? How this painting appear in under sunlight? And apparently, some of the line cannot be seen under torch, meaning this painting was most likely done under sunlight. Why it is important? If this is done under sunlight, or if it is done under torch, first, they completed the tumulus, bringing torch inside and paint. That is relatively easy. If this is done on sunlight, they only create wall and paint. And then after completing painting, put ceiling and then complete tumulus. So again, this kind of 3D data provide new interpretation in archaeology. I'll skip this one. Yeah, actually, we also obtain new findings. And Soma Vesuviana, I'll skip this one. basically, now, let's suppose we have a 3D data. How to display such 3D data? And in my opinion, those data should be shared by all people sitting on cloud computers to any terminals, any occasions, so that everyone can enjoy any time. By using this kind of cloud data, we can motivate to visit a site. We can exhibit and explain such a heritage. And also, while you are visiting, we can provide guide and on-site excitement. And also, we can upload some of the comment to the cloud computer so that share the excitement. Let's take a look at the motivation. Well, this is relatively easy. Basically, prepare a website. And if you click, you can see the areas. And one of the easiest solutions is video base. And this is a scene which we are collecting in Pompeii. This guy wearing a helmet. Yeah, we are enjoying the Pompeii life. And then, you know, by using this video, and we can create this video sequence. Yeah, actually, many systems are existing. But, you know, if you click the map, you can see the videos. 2D is relatively easy, but 3D is issues. And this is huge data, and how to download such huge data to the terminal is quite difficult. So currently, one of my postdoc is working with Redmond's Azure team so that they can download such data to mobile terminal easily. They are calling network rendering. This is a 3D data display on a mobile terminal. Orientation. Basically, when you visit a site, usually there is a visitor center. So visitor center by downloading images and display high resolution theaters, and you can explain why that heritage is important or what is the history, blah, blah, blah. And also by using cyber archaeology results, we can explain. Also, we have to worry about the storytelling. Now let's go to excitement. Some of the Japanese site is like that. Basically, most, you know, in India and Cambodia, most of the heritage is constructed by stone, so existing. But most of the heritage in Japan is made of wood, so unfortunately burned. And this is a very important temple existing around the 6th century, Kawaharadera. But when you visit, there is nothing. And of course, if you have a rich knowledge of history, you are really appreciate these positions. But school kids never really understand what's the meaning of this site. So mayor angry and ask me, is there any way to improve the situations? So I propose, why don't you set up the system when you wear the goggle, you can see ancient capital, ancient temple. That is fantastic. And this is called mixed reality. You can enjoy CG at exactly site with feeling the wind blowing continuously from ancient time. Fusion of current scene with ancient scene. This is called mixed reality. And in this mixed reality, there are a couple of the vision issues, geometric consistency, photometric consistency. I'm mainly working photometric consistency. Basically, this object appears exactly same position, but somehow this looks floating while this guy is on the ground. Why? Because this guy doesn't have shadow while this guy has shadows. And we can make this kind of consistency and solution, blah, 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 blah. Basically, main idea is measuring. And we can generate this kind of shadows. When you see the areas, you can see this kind of CG. And the important point is, this CG changes its color depending on illumination conditions in real time. Occlusions. famous sightseeing area, there are many sightseers, and like this situation often occurs. How to improve? Well, by using so-called segmentation technique, we can remove that effect. And this is background, this is CG, and the important point is, on this CG, shadow is appearing. This guy's shadow is appearing on this CG. This is a scene which we did, Takamatsuzuka. So, you know, real scenes like that, but when you wear the goggle, you can see inside of the tumulus. If you go to Foro Romana, where this kind of situation occurs, and Roma city, if you dig, another ruin exists, so they cannot build anything. So CG, again, mixed reality is the most appropriate solutions. This is vice mayor of Roma city. He's quite happy. Why? Because he's looking over this one, however, reality is like that. Asuka-kyo, well, this overlooking the area to the ancient capital, by, I skip detail, but you know, we can calculate the shadow like that. So on this scene, you can see this kind of images. Let's go more fun portion, visiting. Currently, well, you know, if you go to the famous area such as Roma city, each ruin exists a remote area, so you have to move around. While you are moving, you are wasting time. Is there any way to utilize such time for guidance by using mobile technologies? And our idea is, why don't you wear the goggle while you are moving? And if you enjoy story of the ancient time continuously, then that's much better to and worthwhile. And even we can convert one particular area to the theme park. When some revolution occurs on that particular place, how about other places? If you go, then you can see how that town appear at that particular date. So we can show ancient times one day of one particular areas, entire areas. For that purpose, we utilize this tram. And this tram has 12 goggles, and like this, passenger via this goggle, position is coming from GPS, and direction is e-compass and gyros, and also sound too, and if you change direction, sound different. And of course, illumination estimations. And the important point is, not only building, but also to display some event. And this is one of the Jinshin no Ran, actually very important revolutions occurs. And we show such a movie, or not a movie, image at the particular side. This is a scene. People are riding on a future vehicle, and once they get on, they wear the goggle and headphone. Mixed reality tour. And this person is, the important point is, we create CG of entire capital and bus is running around. So along this route, CG appear, also a background appear, and also not only, and this is a scene, virtually nothing, surround, but reality, but CG is, this is background image. On this background image, we can superimpose CGs, and also people are moving around, and also not only moving around, but also we can display ancient revolutions. Superimpose current scene. So you can really learn what happened at that particular site by just riding this bus. And he's saying, well, this is fantastic. And school kids say, well, just reading history in textbook is not interesting. However, feeling such event by this bus riding is quite important. Now, once you have excitement, probably you want to share such excitement with other people. So we are preparing a communication channel by using this system, and we are building a system to paste your comment on directly to the 3D data so that other people can embody and extract such information. Now, still I have maybe 5-10 minutes, so I will explain another story, a little bit short. Up to here is mainly tangible heritage. We have to also worry about intangible heritage, dance, music, or spoken language, or whatever. And in this particular segment, I'm talking about the Japanese folk dance. And again, Japanese folk dance is vanishing due to the lack of inheritors. And somehow we have to save such situations. Modeling issue, and fortunately, this modeling is relatively easy recently. One of the ideas is sensing technique is drastically improved. One traditional way is a multi-baseline stereo system and observe human along surrounding TV cameras. This is one of the eight sequence, blue back, and extracted background, and then we can generate this kind of 3D. And stick images. Another method is so-called motion capture system, and this is an optical motion capture system. Dancer mount markers, and that marker is observed again surrounding TV camera, and we obtain. Or magnetic capture, and of course, Microsoft Kinect. And by using this kind of technique, we can extract how human is doing. But this is not the end of the story. Rather, this is the beginning of headache. Let's suppose we have a perfect data coming from motion capture data. Can we display by using robot? If we provide this kind of data to robot, falling down. Of course, physical balance of human and physical balance of robot is totally different. Exactly similar situation is occurring while sensor, teacher and student, because teacher's body weight, student body weight totally different. So direct mimicking doesn't work. Rather important point is, while observing, you extract key essence of dance and then replicate such a key essence is basically learning. And key issue is, then what is key representations? And in this case, we divide lower body and upper body. The reason is, purpose of lower body and purpose of upper body is slightly different. Lower body mainly supporting, while upper body is representing dance. So, lower body. In lower body, only three state existing, both foot standing, left standing or right standing actually, and transition is occurring, and squatting. So from the continuous motion capture data, system recognize what's going on right now. Once we obtain such a status, to each state, there is a skill parameter, how to conduct standing, how long standing is occurring, squat, how deep squat is occurring, step, what is the foot size, something like that. And such data is again obtained from motion capture data and modify prototypical trajectory and determine the foot point, foot trajectory. And once you obtain foot trajectory by solving inverse kinematic, you can obtain lower body motion. Now, upper body, I have no idea how to dance. So I ask dance teacher how to dance this Ice Bandai-san dance. And she provides this kind of drawings, like this. Somehow you can dance. And what is that? So we extract this by assumption that brief stop is a key representation when that is corresponding to rhythm of the music. And this is extracted key pose. And in any case, robot cannot mimic everything. So we generate robot which exactly mimic this only key point. And interval is kind of interpolations. Key point, exact. Key point, exact. Transition interpolations. Now this is a result. Music. So these are the story, basically, thank you. 3C, computer vision for e-heritage acquisition, and cloud computing for e-heritage representation, and computer graphics for e-heritage display. And this is a quite important point, important area, so all welcome to work in this area. Thank you very much.